Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about the inputs and outputs on the back of the PreSonus StudioLive 16.0.2 USB. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. Now, if you are a newer audio engineer or even an experienced audio engineer and are looking for some tips and tricks for audio, I have a weekly newsletter that you can sign up for over at audiotoolkit.co. This is a free newsletter that gives you a 5 to 15 minute read in your inbox every week, where it's just some of my favorite audio tips and tricks just for you. But let's go ahead and dive in to this video on talking about the inputs and outputs on the back of this board. Now, in a previous video, I was talking about the channels here, that we have 12 faders of our input channels, and that these last four are our stereo channels. So we can either choose between a mono or a stereo input. And we can do that by selecting our channel and pressing link on these to change them into a stereo channel from mono. Now we also have our four auxes as well as a main output. Now these are also going to be on the back of the board with some individual volume settings that we have on the back of the board, which is unique for mixers. I don't see that very often, which is really cool. Now we also have a talkback input on the back of the board, which allows us to have our talkback channel here, which allows me to take a microphone, plug it into the talkback, and there is a gain adjustment here for my talkback mic. And this allows me to talk to my musicians up on stage through the auxes. So I can define if I want to send it to aux 1 and 2 or aux 3 and 4 by those lights being turned on. Now the talk button is latching, so this, if it's enabled in red, that means the talkback mic is turned on going to those outputs. If the talkback light is off, it is not going to those outputs. We also have our talkback level that we have so that we can define how loud we want our talkback mic into those auxes. In my previous video, I was also talking about the solo section of our board and that we have a headphone jack on the front, but we also have a monitor output on the back of the board, which allows me to put up some near fields at my mixer position and be able to solo or send the mains or even the USB to those outputs. Now let's go ahead and move around to the back of the board and actually talk about the inputs and outputs available to us on the PreSonus Studio Live. So we can see that we have 12 XLR inputs here. So we have input 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 9 has a individual microphone input, a left or mono input, and a right input. So these last four channels, I can either have it be mono by using the microphone input or the mono input, or I can do stereo by plugging into the left and the right, and then on the board activating that as linked. We can see that on our 13 and 14 and 15 and 16 that we also have an RCA input that we can utilize for the input into these channels. We also have our talkback mic that's right here, and phantom power is activated on this input. So just be careful of what microphone you plug into this. We also have our talkback level amount for our preamp gain on the talkback mic. Moving down here, we have our outputs. So we can see that these are our aux outputs for aux 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are a TRS output, so balanced or unbalanced. We then have our monitor output, which is again our solo section if we wanted to plug this into some near field monitors at the mixing position. We then have a main output of left and right on the TRS. We also have an XLR main left and right with an individual volume output for this output, as well as a mono sum of the left and the right going out a single XLR, as well as an output level adjustment for this output. We then have our MIDI in and out to be able to control this via MIDI commands, as well as our USB connection for connecting our board to a computer. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the PreSonus Studio Live, or really any of the other production mixers that are out there, please put that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. brashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.